What's going down, PD peeps? Today, I'm going to show my remarkable PD peeps how to save and produce videos using the PowerDirector Mobile Video Editor app. If you're new to my channel and you want to learn how to use PowerDirector, click the subscribe button and click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. When you save a video, it allows you to return to the project using PowerDirector to make more edits. Producing a video creates a video file that could be uploaded to YouTube or saved to your device for viewing at a later time. Now that you know the difference between the two, I'm going to be Captain Save a Video and help you out. First, let's talk about saving videos. What you want to do is you want to open up a new project and you want to give it a name. When you do, then you want to tap on the aspect ratio you're going to use. And it opens up the screen so you can go and pick out your media. Let's say I want to put some videos on here. And I'm just going to tap this video and hit the plus sign. Tap this one and hit the plus sign. And I'm good to go. So now I want to do back. And now I'm ready to save this video. So if I hit the home button, you see that it automatically saves a video under the projects called Cray Cray Town. So if I ever want to go ahead and get back to this video, all I need to do is open it up and I'm back in that video. Now I can also save this as a different version of the same project. So let's say I go ahead and open up Cray Cray Town by tapping on it. Now I can go ahead and tap on Save As, and I can give it a different name. And then I can go ahead and tap on OK. And now if I open that project and I go ahead and hit on edit project, I can now, let's say, add some more videos, the media icon, go to videos again, go ahead and tap this and add this video to the front. And if I hit back and I hit home, now I have Cray Cray Town, but I also have Cray Cray Town version 2 because I saved it as a new one. So if I need to go back to the first version, I can just tap on Cray Cray Town. But if I need to go to the second version, I can tap on Cray Cray Town 2. All right, so that's how you get your save on. Now the last topic of the day is produce. In order to go ahead and produce a video, you need to go ahead and tap on the project that you want to use. Now, this screen used to have a produce icon right here on the screen, but in this version of PowerDirector Mobile that we're currently using, it does not have the option to produce. So in order to produce the video, you have to tap on Edit Project. Once you get here, you have to tap on this produce icon up in the right upper corner of your screen. As you can see, there are multiple options. So you can save to a gallery card or an SD card. If you tap on that, it'll give you the options of 4K, HD, Full HD, SD. Then you got some settings that you can change at the bottom, and you got your produce button. Then you have Facebook, you got YouTube, got more options, and you got the cloud. So we're going to stick with more output options at this time. And I'm going to show you some of the settings. So for this, we're going to go ahead and keep it on Ultra HD, and then you can tap on settings. When you tap on settings, you have a few options. First is a save location. So you tap on that and it gives you a internal storage location, or if you have an external device plugged in, then it'll give you an option to save it to that external device. So let's go ahead and pick internal storage. And then you have your bitrate. So if you tap on bitrate, it gives you three options: better quality, standard quality, and smaller size. If you select better quality, of course, you're going to have a better looking image, but the size of your file is going to be larger. And because of that, it's going to take up more space on your drive or on your device. So we're going to go ahead and select better quality. And then the last option you have on here is your frame rate. So if you tap on that, you can choose between 24 frames per second, which is usually used for movies. Then you have 30 frames per second and you have 60 frames per second. We're going to keep it on 24 frames per second. And then when you're done, you just go ahead and tap on OK. So now all your settings are locked in. Then you want to tap on Next, and it'll produce the movie for you. It'll go ahead and give it a name based on the name that you gave your project. And now it'll give you some options of what you can do with it. If you tap on Smart View, you'll go ahead and view it on your device, but then it has some options here to share it to different locations, a box. It's a lot of different things that you can do with it. Send it to an email, email it to someone else. All the good choices that you could ever dream of. Saving and producing is all that we're using. I know that's not a word, but I just threw it in there. If you like what you see, I'll leave a link to try out PowerDirector Mobile in the video description. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my logo to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.